Welcome to the Swans Show, your weekly update on all things Swansea City. Coming up this week, we go to Morriston Hospital with Martin Olsson and Alfie Mawson. We get the verdict on the Swans season from the Liberty Press Box. But first, we've come to meet a living Swansea City legend, if he'll let us in.
Gaz,
here he is, welcome, Leon mate. Britton. Thanks, mate. How you doing?
Yeah, good, thank you.
Good man. We've got a real treat on the Swans Show this week. We're playing a game of pool with a living Swansea City legend. Leon, your shot.
Cheers, Gaz.
Nice table, Brit.
It's not bad to be fair. I got it. I was looking when I bought the outside, the pool table right in there.
And, oh, did you?
Yeah. Well, I bought it off the previous owners. And obviously I wanted to do the games room up here, and I looked online at the pool cloths and found a company and put in the idea to get the Swans badge and, and bits and pieces in there. So
what are you laughing at?
No, I'm chuffed with it.
Oh my God.
Is it two shots or is it?
Oh yeah. That's right, isn't it?
I'm too honest, I am.
I haven't played this game for a while.
Oh my God, mate, where you left me with here?
So on the wall, Leon, you've got some mementos of your career.
Yeah, I've got a few.
Few of your shirts. Which of your shirts are on the wall?
I've got a few shirts. I've got this one's the playoff final.
Right.
Beating Reading.
Signed by all your teammates?
Yeah, signed by all the team, manager. There's a few funny messages on there. I think we've done it on the bus on the way home, so a few people had a few drinks.
Any good ones?
Brendan. That one.
The King Returns.
The King Returns, a hero. Yeah.
Got like that.
And then you've got a couple of other Swans.
Well, this one is the Capital One final when we beat Bradford.
Another trip to Wembley, another win.
Another trip to Wembley, mate. A bit different that day, wasn't it? It was 5-0. It was
relaxed, unlike that one.
Yeah, it was a bit more relaxed, wasn't it? But no, that was history that day, wasn't it? Obviously, our first major trophy as a football club. But that was a great day. It was still, you know, my first major honour as well in football. So,
Is that the best day you've had, do you think, or would it probably be that one?
probably the playoff final.
Because of what it meant, that one.
Probably, yeah. I think, you know, you work hard all your career to get to the top, and then to do it that day was a great day. So I think that one ranks up as, you know, in the top three games I've had at the football club.
I better have another shot. Is it my go? Can't remember.
Yeah, it's your go, mate. You ain't potted, have you?
No,
you haven't. You haven't potted, no.
But then you haven't potted anything either, have you? Apart from the one you fouled on. Well, hang about. Here we go.
Tactical, is it? You're not going to put that one, huh?
I've left myself in a good spot here.
Watch the Lampard shirt, mate.
So, another Swans one here.
Yeah, that one's...
Is that the whole game?
That's the whole game. Yeah, so I've got... I tried to get the majority of the lads to... I think most of the lads are on there. That's the... that's the whole City game.
You were carried off. I remember the pictures of you getting carried off.
I got a bit stuck in there, didn't I?
Surprised you didn't get the shirt lifted off your back.
Well, they did take a few things like socks and boots and bits and pieces, but I managed to keep hold of the shirt. But obviously, it's, in the club's history, it's probably, you could argue,
the biggest one of the lot.
The biggest one of the lot, probably, with the consequence of potentially going down and out of the Football League, which hasn't happened to the football club. So the shirts were a bit bigger back then. You didn't get the choice of the different sizes, as you can tell.
The club budget didn't stretch the different sizes in those days.
One shirt for a season, mate, so you had to make sure it lasted well.
Go on, your go.
Is it my go, is it?
I think so.
I need to pop one, mate, that's what I need to do.
Concentrate, you can't lose to me. You might have thought when that whole shirt, Leon, you didn't know if that was your last ever appearance in the shirt at the time, did you?
Well, I spoke to West Ham in the summer of that year, and they were happy to let me go, you know. I had a year left on my contract and they was happy to let me go.
Yeah.
And I spoke to my agent and I just said to him, I enjoyed it so much at Swansea. I wasn't bothered about trying to
go up the leagues.
You know, go up the leagues or try and sign for somewhere else. Maybe I could have. I don't know, to be honest with you. But
you didn't worry about it.
No, I felt as well. I owed the football club. I owed the football club something as well. Not bad, mate. They give me the opportunity. They give me the opportunity when no one else would.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't even put one in.
There was that one little bit where you went had a little holiday in Yorkshire, wasn't there?
Injury. Yeah. Six months injury.
Yeah. Looking back, do you wish you'd never done that?
Yeah, I mean, of course I wish, you know, I didn't have that break away from the football club, but I think it's easy to say it now when, you know, you look back on your career, there's probably things in everyone's career that they wish they'd done differently and, you know, or didn't do.
You came back just in time for the trip to Wembley. Yeah.
No, I timed it well, like. Yeah. You've got to give me that.
And then you've got various other shirts on the wall. I think there's another couple.
This one's the first season in the Premier League.
Just gonna see if I can pop one while you're.
Oh, you spawny. Yeah, no, that one's the first my first Premier League shirt. So.
Right.
You know, a special one just for, you know, getting to the Premier League first season in the top flight. Again, just got the boys to sign that one. And the good thing
is that Manchester City?
Yeah, it'd probably be Man City, that one. And the good thing is on there, you know, there's a lot of players on there who've been together through the leagues, like, you know, obviously, you know, Monks and Tatey. There's other lads, obviously, Angel and Ash, you know, who come from League One or the Championship. We've been together a long time, so.
That unusual, isn't it?
Yes.
As we all know, that's why it's been such a great.
But that was why it was special for us. Like, you know, we all come up together. We become good mates because we've played together a long time.
And,
so that one's a special one because it's the first year.
And down there.
Yeah, this is
last game at the Vetch, is it?
Last game at the Vetch, yeah. So, obviously, that's a special shirt for obvious reasons, mate. Isn't it? You know, the last match at the Vetch Field.
Shrewsbury Town,
yeah.
Adrian Forbes scored past against Joe Hart.
Against Joe Hart, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a good goal.
These are big pockets, mine, aren't they?
Right, it's getting tense here. No pressure. And then various non-Swan shirts on the wall as well, Leon, in here.
Yeah, I mean, the majority of the shirts.
Most
in
of the
there
people you've played
with, yeah. A lot of them are people that have either played alongside or trained alongside, or kind of know.
A lot of the West Ham, the old West Ham.
Yeah, obviously Carrick, you know, Jermaine, Joe Cole. For me, it was like not an important thing, but it was something I wanted to do was get their shirts. You know.
So they are actually the genuine swapped after you played them, these ones.
Yeah.
And there's Joe, of course, your old mate.
Yeah, Joe. So obviously played against him at Liverpool. That wasn't bad, mate.
That was a good shot. he's a good friend of yours, isn't he, Joe?
Yeah, he's a good.
You taught him all he knows, didn't you, about playing in midfield?
Taught him a little bit, mate. So I used to pick him up and bring him to training, and you could see, obviously, from a young age, mate, that he was training with the first team. He was going to be a big
a star.
Yeah. There you go, mate.
Shot. So it was a bit of shake your hand.
Well, I had to win, mate.
It wasn't a thrashing.
I took it a bit easy, mate. But
you're still going strong. Everyone keeps asking you about retirement and all this sort of thing. But you started the first game of the season. I'm sure you would have been involved against Manchester United as well, but for a little injury. But you're all right now, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm right now. Yeah, no, I feel okay. I feel pretty strong. Obviously, started the first game, but picked up a back spasm, which now and again flares up, which it has done over the last.
You've had that for a while, haven't you?
But for the last 10 years, really, on and off, you know, it just flares up and you have to let it settle down. But I'm hoping to be back training Thursday, you know, 2 days before the Palace game. But now I feel okay, I feel strong. But yeah, of course, I understand that I'm 35, in 3 or 4 weeks' time, that people are going to ask the question, When am I going to finish at Swansea and when am I going to retire? But I've got the year's contract at the moment with the option of another year if I hit a certain amount of games. So if I do it, the amount of games, then I'll go another year. If I don't, then obviously that's something I'll have to think about in the summer or when the time comes, what I'll do.
You've already thought about that, haven't you? Coaching, you've done a bit of media work, but I think coaching is your plan, isn't it, to do something at the club?
Yeah, coaching, I think, is something that I'll probably look to do. Sitting next to teammates, go into it, you know, how much they enjoy it. And I've done a bit of my coaching badges with the FAW. I've enjoyed that. I also enjoyed doing some media work. I've done, you know, some TV, some radio, you know, different bits and pieces. So that's something that I could look at. But I think I'd like to stay involved in the football club. And that's something I spoke about with the chairman, the manager, the owners. So probably coaching would be probably the perfect role for me to stay on in the football club in some capacity. What level and what role that is, I don't know. That's something that you need to discuss when the time comes.
You've had so many happy times in a Swans shirt. What would make you happy this year as a team, do you think?
You know, I don't want to put a place on it mid-table. And we
but out of the picture at the bottom?
Out of the picture at the bottom, you know, maybe the playing style kind of coming back through. And one other thing that maybe we haven't done since I've probably been at the club is a good FA Cup run. You know, we had one many years ago, maybe when Brian Flynn was manager. But apart from that, we seem to go out early. So, you know, a good FA Cup run would be nice, because since I've been here, I can't remember the last one.
Maybe one more shirt to go on your wall, the Wembley FA Cup shirt.
It'd be a decent one, wouldn't it? Yeah, that'd be, if it was to be, you know, the end, not that I'm saying that, but an FA Cup one would... FA Cup final one would be nice to go alongside the League Cup and all the rest of them.
Let's hope it happens. Thanks, Leon.
Fingers crossed.
Time.
Cheers.
Brilliant.
Thank you.
All the best, mate.
Cheers, mate.
Cheers. A couple of hours till kick-off, Swans v Manchester United, the first home game of the season. We're just off into the press room to see what a few of the people who follow the Swans from the press box think about the season ahead.
I'd like to think a continuation of the second half of last season, really.
I think that Swansea start to get their identity back. I think that's what Paul Clement was most proud of.
You saw how much he got the defence organised, how much he tightened things, how well team spirit seems to be going.
It's all built on this calm, stable environment. Hopefully Paul Clement will do that. I've been impressed with him as a coach.
You can see the organisation that Paul Clement's brought in.
Yes, there were some really good additions last January, but it also shows the value of someone who's a really good coach, who does the work on the training ground that makes a difference.
You see that Paul Clement has had his way with the players on the training ground, hard work.
He's had a full pre-season now with the players, so you'd think he'd got his messages across to them.
There is cause for optimism. Martin Olsson, Tom Carroll, they've both done really well.
Yeah, I think Tom Carroll, you know, made a real impression when he came in January. You know, he brings a real energy to the midfield area.
People have been telling me great things about Tammy Abraham despite his age.
I think everyone has a little bit of optimism looking forward to the season, naturally.
So I'm really keen to see Rocky Messer play, what he'll bring to this Swansea team, and Tammy Abraham as well up front. I think that's a new option for Swansea with his pace and his movement.
We want a season that the fans can enjoy.
Swansea's success has come when there hasn't been a star. The team has been the star.
Going back to some of the previous seasons when they were a team that was playing exciting football and, you know, targeting top half finishes, really, that's where you want to see the club. And I think there's no reason, if they invest well between now and the end of the window, why they can't be doing that.
You know, we want Swansea to be doing really well under Paul Clement, and hopefully kicking on, you know, fingers crossed, towards a top half finish if possible.
One of the things that I've really warmed to is the fact that a lot of the values here, I think, are the values that the club had when they were coming up through the leagues. It doesn't feel like just another Premier League club in that respect. So, yeah, long may their top flight status continue, really.
The Swans were beaten 4-0 by Manchester United in their opening home game of the season. A harsh scoreline given that Paul Clement's team were right in the contest until the final 10 minutes. They bounced back at MK Dons on Tuesday with two Leroy Fair goals and further strikes from Tammy Abraham and Jordan Ayew, sealing a first win of the campaign and a place in the Carabao Cup third round. There was more good news on Wednesday as the Swans completed the signing of Hull City midfielder Sam Klukas, with Stephen Kingsley moving in the opposite direction.
So firstly, tell us why we're here today.
You're here as part of our positivity and team building to help with the staff recruitment, staff retention. We have a little problem at the moment on the unit with retaining staff, and we thought it'd be a good idea to get everyone together as a team building to try and form a calendar and raise funds towards that team building and towards comfort of staff, because we're not always thought of first.
So as part of that, you've called on the Swans to come and get involved. Yeah. Tell us who's been down today.
Lee Trundle, we've had Alfie Mawson and Martin Olsson, which is fabulous for us.
It's fantastic. It's going to help us to raise awareness. It's going to help us sell the calendars. And it's just brilliant for morale for the staff.
It's huge, because the funds are going to be directed towards the nurses, and the doctors, the multidisciplinary team, towards the coffee room, improving that, making it more comfortable, boost morale. It goes towards the team building efforts that we're doing. We're going to do some team building with them and use that money towards that.
It was nice to come down here to the hospital and, you know, support the cause as well. I mean, the calendar, I think it put a lot of smile to people's faces, and I've heard it's going to raise a bit of money as well.
It's going to be good, isn't it, that the money raised from this calendar that you Swans have been involved with helps go back into helping the team building here at the hospital?
Yeah, it's a good thing. You need it everywhere, not even in football, but as well at the hospital as well, you know. You need to stick together and have a smile on the face, and hopefully, you know, this will change a bit of that. But I think it's for a good cause, so all of us always we want to be involved in that.
Thank you so much for coming and supporting us. It means so much.
Yeah, it is.
Thank you.
Really appreciate it. As a huge Swans fan, we really appreciate the support.
Hi, I'm Martin Olsson. You're watching the Swans Show.